Hello everyone, I hope you all are enjoying learning pandas. In this session we are going to learn a bit more about data frame, and we are going to learn about data frame attributes, data frame conversion, and also we are going to learn about iterating over elements of data frame. So let's begin. As you know, this is the data set which we have, and if I just print it, this is the data frame which we have. And now I already shown you that if we do df.columns, then we can see name of all the columns. Okay, so this is columns is just one attribute of data frame. Similarly, we have many other attributes which can be used to get different information about data frames. Okay, so for example, you can do df.index, and this is going to give you information about index of this data frame. So as you can see, it is saying that it is giving us information about the index. It is saying the starting point of the index is 0 and it is ending at 255, and it is increasing by 1. Okay, so that is the information about index. And we can get information about, you know, total number of rows and columns of a data frame as well by using df.shape. I guess I already shown you this one. Now this is giving you information about total number of rows and columns. Now let's say you just want to know total number of cells, which means the multiplication of 255 by 12. So in that case you can do df.size, and this is going to tell you what is the total number of cells, or you can say, you know, the individual information available, which is going to be total multiplication of total number of rows by total number of columns. Okay, so now there is other property which is very important which we can use, and that is used mostly when you want to perform some sort of, you know, condition before you want to perform any operation on data frame. So this is called checking whether the data frame is empty or not empty. Okay, so there is a property which is called df.empty, and if I run it, it is going to give me false, because right now we have information in data frame. Now let's suppose there is no data available in this file. Okay, in that case it is basically going to load nothing in data frame, and the data frame is going to be completely empty. So in that case, if you want to do a validation before performing any operation on data frame, then you can use if df empty, then you can just say that you can just exit probably here, or you can break, you can do whatever you want to do. Okay, so you can do something here, and also for in else condition you can do remaining of the work, which is, you know, performing operations on data frame. Now this is going to be very useful, because sometimes you just start working on data frame but you realize the data frame itself is empty and the program is going to throw the error. Okay, so it's always good practice that you check whether the data frame is having data or not. So there are many other attributes as well, but these are the important ones which we are going to use, or which is being used very frequently when you work on pandas as a developer or data analyst. Okay, now let's move on to conversions. So we are going to see how we can convert a data type from one type to another, and for that the syntax is pretty simple. First thing which we are going to do is let's read some of the records from this data frame. Okay, and now let's say what I want is I want to convert this preparation time to string. Okay, because probably we want to do some operations, and that's why we need to convert it to a string. Okay, so in that case what we can do is we can use df dot name of the column, which is going to be prep time in this case, and then we can say as type, and here we need to define what is the data type which we want to convert it to. Okay, now before I run it, I'm just going to move it to next cell, and in this cell I'm going to run df.dtypes and going to run it, so I can show you again that prep time is actually a float. Okay, and now we are going to convert it to a string. Do df.prep_time equal to this. So what it is going to do is it is going to convert the data frame, original data frame, and then we can print df dot dtypes again. Okay, so I'm going to run it first, and then we are going to run this next cell, and now we can see that prep time has been converted to object. Okay, so previously it was float and now it has been converted to object. Now there can be various scenarios in which you want to convert a column, and you want to, you know, keep the value in a list. Okay, and then later on you might want to perform some operation using that list. Okay, so to do this kind of conversion, you can use df dot, and you need to define the name of the column. So in this case it is going to be, let's say we want to keep all the food names in a list, so we are going to say df dot name dot to underscore list, and what this is going to return is, this is going to return a list of all the food names. Okay, so if I run it, it is going to print the complete list, but alternatively you can also keep it in a variable, and let's call it food names, and then we can print food names. Okay, so you can see this is a complete list. Now let's talk about how we can get some specific information from a data frame. So for that there are a couple of methods which we are going to use, and the first one is get function. Okay, so we are going to say df name dot get, and we need to specify the index number from where we want to get the, you know, the value from. So here, let's say if I specify 0 and I run it, I'm going to get Balushahi. Okay, so I'm just gonna do df dot head here. Let's do 3. Now you can see the 0th element in name was Balushahi. Now let's say you can change it to 2, and you can run it again, and in this case what you are getting is information about name which is available at second index. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Now we are going to move on to other example in which we are going to use df dot add, and we are going to specify index and column. So here if you wanted to get some information, you had to specify the name of the column. So for example, let's say if I want to get information about state, I have to specify column name state, and if I run it, it is giving me information about state column at position of index 2, which is Punjab. Now we can do the similar thing using df dot add, and to use it we are going to say df dot add, and we need to specify the index number, which is, let's say in this case, number 2, and then we need to specify which column we want to get the value from. So I'm just gonna say ingredients, and I'm going to run it, and now we have this piece of information extracted. Okay, so this is very useful when you want to, you know, get some specific information available at some specific index number and from a certain column. Now let's say if you don't want to specify this column name, you just want to get reference the column name based on its position. Okay, so first column is at position 0, second is at position 1, and so on. So now let's say if you want to, we don't want to use column name, we want to use column name based on its position. In that case we can use df dot I add, and we can specify 2, and if we want information about ingredients, which is available at number 1, okay, position number 1, remember a position of column numbers also starts at index 0, so this is position number 0 and this is 1, so here I'm going to specify 1, and if I run it, we are now having the same information which we were having by using this piece of code. Again, you can change the index number to get information from any other column. So for example, if I want to know the cook time, I can change it to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is going to be 4. And if I run it, it is giving me 60, because as we know, Gajar ka halwa takes around 60 minutes to cook. Now we are going to learn about some iterations. Okay, so let's say if you want to iterate over data frame, then what are the different ways you can do it? So we are going to learn how we can iterate over all the values of a column. So for that, what we need to do is we need to specify data frame dot name of the column, so which is name in this case, and then we need to say items. Okay, and I'm going to take it in a for loop. So we are saying for food name in this, and we are going to print all the food names. And if I run it, this is the information we get. So we get name of all the foods, and it's a tuple. So if you know about Python basics, you already know about that this is returning data in a tuple format. Now we are going to move on to next example. In the next example, we are going to iterate over all the records. So we are going to iterate record by record, and we are going to learn how we can achieve that. So for that, we are going to say df dot, or let's start with the for loop. We are going to say for index and value in df dot iterate rows. So this is the syntax. And if I say print value, then let's see what happens. Now you see we are having all the information about basically we have all the values from the data frame. And if I want to perform now operation with individual columns, I can do that, or I can refer to individual columns by specifying the column name here. So I can say name, which is going to print only the name of all the food. And let's do one more thing. I'm just going to write type of, which is going to let us know what is the type of this value. I'm sorry, it is type, it is not type of. So now you can see this is returning string. So you will be able to perform all the string operations which you can perform using Python. So that's all I had in this session. And in this session we learned about some of the important attributes of data frame, and we also learned about conversion and iteration. Now one more important thing before we sign off, that is about transformation. So if I just do df here, we can see that we are having name of all the columns here, and we are having index name here, and then we have all the values here. Now let's say we want to transpose this. If you know about transpose, or you have worked on Excel transpose, then the transpose, probably you already understand what a transpose is. That if I do transpose, then all the column names is going to be shown here, and all the indexes are going to be moved here at this column position. So to do that in data frame, it's very easy. You just need to specify df dot capital T, and then you can run it. Now you can see all the names have moved here on the left side, and all the index number has gone here on the acting as a column name. Okay, so this is how you can do a transformation. You don't really need to write any lengthy code to transform. So I hope you liked the video. If you liked, do not forget to like the video, and also do share any comment, or do share any tips you have or suggestion you have for upcoming video. Thank you so much for watching.